Hi, welcome into this special Advent episode of the Lockdown Lectionary. We're continuing today to look at some ideas inspired by UCC Pastor Quinn Caldwell's Advent devotional book, All I Really Want. Last time, we talked about how much we miss out on if we don't embrace Jesus' practice of talking and teaching and thinking metaphorically. Today, we're going to extend that idea of looking at Scripture in a non-literal sort of way by looking at a story from Acts chapter 9. Now, as he was going along and approaching Damascus, suddenly a light from heaven flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, "Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me?" He asked, "Who are you, Lord?" The reply came, "I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. But get up and enter the city, and you will be told what you are to do." The men who were traveling with him stood speechless because they heard the voice, but saw no one. Saul got up from the ground, and though his eyes were open, he could see nothing. So they led him by the hand and brought him into Damascus. For 3 days he was without sight and neither ate nor drank. Well, of course, this is the well-known story of Saul on his way to Damascus and his dramatic conversion to become one of the biggest champions of the teachings and ethics of Jesus. Quinn Caldwell notes that if you look up the Wikipedia article on this story, you can find all sorts of interesting theories of what really happened, including one researcher who writes that the experience sounds like, quote, an attack of temporal lobe epilepsy, perhaps ending in a convulsion which was startling and dramatic. The blindness which followed may have been post-ictal. Well, whoever wrote that certainly has more time on their hands than I do. The point is that it's possible, with a lot of rhetorical gymnastics, to explain just about any supernatural story in the Bible. Paul had a seizure. The Red Sea parted due to an unusually strong windstorm. The plagues of Egypt were caused by a rare confluence of weather-related events. You get the idea. And maybe all of these explanations hold water and could be absolutely correct. Even if they are, would it really surprise us to know that God could use windstorms or epilepsy to good ends? Just because we can explain it through science doesn't necessarily mean that God is not behind it in some form or fashion. And that's especially important to remember this time of year. There are all sorts of miraculous parts of the Christmas story. Psychic dreams, virgin births, angels and stars, just to name a few. We might be tempted to try to explain all of these things. But what good does it do us to do that? Miracle stories are not supposed to be explained. I'm certain that not everything in the Bible happened exactly as it says it did. And that's okay, because that leads us to have a better perspective as we consider these stories. The point of these miracle stories is not to prompt us to ask how these things happened, but why did they happen? Thinking in that way can often make all of the difference. Let's pray. God, you are so beyond our comprehension. Help us to suspend our critical minds to embrace the mystery of your grace. Amen. Well, thanks for joining me for this episode of the Lockdown Lectionary. In the comments below, you'll find today's musical selection, as well as a link to Quinn Caldwell's book. Be safe, stay at home, and wear your masks. Peace be with you.